and the beach, Sandy Neck Beach, which maybe should be called Rocky Neck Beach, because it's very rocky here, and the best time actually to walk here is at low tide, when the sand at low tide is very firm. In the summer, this area is covered with RVs camping out here, and day vehicles coming in here, off-road vehicles coming in here to have summer fun. But I don't come here then, too crowded for me. It is a 6 mile long barrier beach running between Cape Cod Bay over there to the north, and over here we have the Great Marsh to the south. Here I am with Kane, the black one here, and Pippa, the female out ahead. And there are four trails, connecting trails, that cross from the beach to the marsh. Trails 1, 2, 4, and 5. Here we are at trail 1 that cuts through the dunes from Sandy Neck Beach to the marsh. I don't think there ever was a trail 3 for some strange reason, but that's New England logic for you. You just go from trail 2 to trail 4. And from trail 4, there's a nice trail that goes through the interior of the dunes, trail 5. And that's one of the few cases where there is a trail through the interior. The best part of Sandy Neck is in the interior, like here, this interdunal swale with a wild cranberry bog over here. I've collected cranberries here and made cranberry sauce. Oh, very sour, very sour. Be careful of poison ivy, but this is the best place to be, the interior of the dunes. There are signs that say you're not supposed to come in here, but the hunters do in the winter. And I come in here in the winter. Like a cold day like this, there's nobody else here. A lot of seasonal wildlife here. In the fall, you get swarms of swallows feasting on the bayberries. In the springtime, the peepers come out, the little frogs that make a melodic peeping sound. And how do you get here? You drive along 6A from Barnstable to Sandwich. Just at the Barnstable Sandwich line, you will come upon Sandy Neck Road. Take a right turn on Sandy Neck Road. Go down the road to the gate to Bodfish Park and Sandy Neck. Go through the gate. During the winter, nobody checks to see if you have a beach access sticker, although you need to have a resident sticker or pay a fee to get in during the summer. Off-islanders don't like that.